Today I'm going to talk you through one of the less common types of ankle sprains called a deltoid ligament sprain or a medial ankle ligament sprain. Within this video we're going to talk you through how people get this injury, what the symptoms are, how to diagnose it. We're also going to talk you through why some of these cases don't get better and some tips and tricks that you can try to try and encourage your ankle mobility to improve if that's something that you struggle with. We're also going to talk you through the best treatment for this condition and we're going to give you some exercises that you can try to rehabilitate your medial ankle sprain. So first of all, we need to look at the anatomy of the medial ankle joint. So you can see that it's made up of the medial malleolus, and then the bigger bone towards the bottom is the calcaneus, and then you've got some smaller tarsal bones moving towards the foot. As we look at the deltoid ligament, you can see that it's triangular in shape, and it's formed of four separate ligaments that all mesh together to form what looks like a web. And this web of ligaments is made up of two different aspects. You've got a superficial layer that sits on the outside, and then you've got a deeper layer that sits underneath that, and that tends to be the one that gives more problems in those ankle sprains that don't resolve, and we'll talk a little bit more about that later. Up to 70% of the population will get affected by an ankle sprain at some stage in their life. Up to half of all ankle sprains come as a result of athletic activity, and up to 15% of ankle sprains don't resolve. And medial ankle sprains account for up to 15% of all forms of ankle sprains. So the shape of the ankle joint itself means that the medial malleolus is slightly bigger than the lateral malleolus, therefore it gives more structural integrity to the ankle, so it's harder to sprain that ankle than the one on the outside, and that's why it's a little bit less common. It generally takes quite a bit of force to sprain this deltoid ligament, so typically we'd see that in sport where you might get a force coming from the outside moving inward, and that makes the ankle invert, placing stress on the ligaments and causing irritation or a tear to the ligament. Other times that we might see it is when there's more pace involved. So if we land from a jump, so often that we might see that in basketball, if someone lands on someone else's foot, or if they struggle to stabilize as they land on the ground, you can get that sudden inward movement of the ankle, and that really stresses the deltoid ligaments. Less common causes are from adult acquired flat foot, so that's where the foot flattens over time. It starts to stretch the ligaments gradually and they start to attenuate, getting little bits of degradation and small tears in them over time. That leads them to become stretched, less stable, and that results in more instability in your ankle. So in severe cases where we see a complete rupture of the deltoid ligaments is usually in instances where there's ankle dislocations or a complete break of the ankle joint. So what do symptoms of this look like? Well, in the really acute phases, we often struggle to weight bear. The pain is mostly towards the inside of the ankle. It's often a sharp pain when we turn the ankle outwards. If you're getting pain when you turn the ankle inwards, it's often a sign that the deeper fibers of the deltoid ligament are affected, and that can often give other complications which we'll touch on later. Other symptoms might include pain when walking on the inside of the ankle, instability as we walk, and often immediately after the injury there might be some swelling in the area, and that might really balloon up if you have a complete rupture, and they're often associated with a click or a sudden pop when the injury occurs. Thinking about the more chronic cases, what we often see in those patients is that they really struggle with exercises like a knee to wall test. They feel like they have limited motion in the ankle, and it's often associated with a pinch on the inside of the ankle or slightly towards the front of the ankle while they try these activities. So that's normally got to do with the deep fibers of that deltoid ligament, and they become a little bit pinched underneath the medial malleolus as you move forward. It's often associated with synovitis of the joint, so that's a type of swelling that you get within the capsule of the ankle joint, and that can really limit the motion of the ankle, and that tends to be the main thing that slows down rehab. Later on in the video, we'll touch on different exercises and steps that you can take to try and improve that motion in the ankle. In terms of clinically diagnosing this injury, it's relatively straightforward. We tend to carry out a normal examination of the strength, mobility and flexibility of the ankle, and then carry out special tests like the Kleger's test, which is to test the integrity of the deltoid ligament. We try to rule out other conditions and other tissues that run through that structure, so things like the flexor latus longus tendon and the posterior tibial tendon, which will run along that inside groove, and we try to rule out other neurological conditions like tarsal tunnel syndrome. If we think it's a severe case or there's high levels of instability in the ankle, we'll often refer for an ultrasound scan. It's more cost effective and more easily accessible. That gives us an idea of the integrity of the ligaments, gives us an idea of the state of play with the tendons that run around those ligaments, and it can give us some insight into the bony structure. However, if we want a really detailed image, often we refer for an MRI. You've had a deltoid ligament injury, it's relatively acute, how do you manage it at home? Well, the best advice that we can do is to try and follow the police protocol. So historically, the more well-known protocol is the RICE protocol, which is rest, ice, compression, elevation. While we know that's helpful, if we try and protect and optimally load the joint as quickly as possible, improves the function, it stops the ankle getting too stiff and the building up of synovitis within the joint. This should be carried out ideally under the guidance of a physical therapist. If that's not available to you, try and carry out mobility exercises in a pain-free range as much as possible. So things that you could do at home are simple balance exercises like standing on one leg. If you have access to a swimming pool, just to get your leg moving is really helpful, even if that's just aqua walking up and down, jogging on the spot, or simple paddling in the water. That usually helps to manage your swelling, helps to keep mobility in the joint. And if you have access to a stationary bike, that's really helpful as well, as the non-impact circular motion of the exercise helps to pump fluid out of there, pump swelling out of there, and again helps with improving the range of motion and decreasing the pain within the joint. Then in terms of physical therapy, so if we think about the acute phases first, what we might try is some taping of the joint just to give it some stability and help them ligaments repair in an optimal position. We generally begin with some banded exercises like these two.
With a band around your foot and the other foot holding the band in place, slowly lift your foot up towards the ceiling against the resistance of the band. Place a loop around the band, use your other foot to hold the band in place, lift your foot up against the resistance of the band, and then move it back and forth, trying to keep your foot in a neutral position throughout, and your foot should feel the tension on the inside of your ankle.
And that's usually complemented with some stretching exercises. We need to be really careful with these that we don't pinch the ankle, so there shouldn't be any pain at the front or the side of the ankle when we try them. So normally, for that reason, we try them from a neutral position, so not off the edge of a step like these ones.
Place one foot in front of the other. Keep the back leg straight while bending the front leg until you feel tension on the back of your calf muscle while keeping your heel on the floor. Adopt the same position, but bend the back leg so you feel the stretch lower down towards the bottom of your calf and Achilles.
And then we normally add in some simple balance exercises, so just eyes open, eyes closed balance exercises, normally in the corner of a room so that you don't deviate too much left and right, don't place too much stress on those injured ligaments. So when we think about the more chronic cases of deltoid ligament sprains, that most of your pain is gone, but you're really struggling with your range of motion, and when you try and push it into that zone, you get a little bit of a pinch. There's usually two things at play here. One is you've got some synovitis within the joint that's limiting the joint motion, and the ankle joint has become stiff itself. So normally we recommend patients to start some of these MWM mobility exercises. Then we need to think about supporting that ankle and taking it out of a provocative position. So often we give patients advice on footwear. So you might look for a trainer that has some medial posting, so that's a bit of a tilt on the outside. It might seem a little bit counterintuitive to turn the ankle inward, but what that does is it shortens the distance of the ligaments from their attachment sites, helps to offload them, gives them a little bit of time to recover, and helps reduce the inflammatory levels within the ankle joint. And so we look at shoes like the Asics Gel Keanu 30 or the New Balance 860 V13s. Then, unfortunately, we've got some patients who'll do all the right type of rehab, try to manage it in the correct manner, and still they have reduced ankle motion and stiffness and pain. For those patients, we often refer them to our colleagues, and they usually perform an ultrasound-guided injection where it's appropriate, especially if it's synovitis that's causing most of the issues. So that's a steroid anti-inflammatory injection, helps to reduce inflammation levels within the ankle joint. It's very much a symptom reliever, so it gives us a window of opportunity to persevere with the rehab that we weren't able to do because of pain levels. So normally we allow 2 weeks post-injection for the ankle to settle down. In that period, you do some gentle mobility and band exercises, and then once we start to see some improvement in pain levels, then we try and progress back into the rehabilitation. If you're looking for some more end-stage rehabilitation exercises that we will perform, these are three of the exercises that are personal favourites of ours.
Use the band to apply resistance, pulling outward against the ankle, and slowly lift your heel up and down, placing weight through your big toe and maintain stability throughout. Place the band on the opposite side to stimulate the peroneal tendons, again trying to hold your ankle stable with weight through your big toe. Place a band around your big toe, take your opposite foot off the floor, and providing resistance against the band, slowly lift your big toe up and down while trying to maintain neutral arch height throughout.
So if you've tried all of this, and unfortunately you're in the very minute med cases that don't resolve, some of these patients then get referred on to our orthopedic colleagues, and they may perform an arthroscopy or an investigation to see if there's anything clogging up the joint, any scar tissue, clean out any synovitis of the joint, and then they recommence to physical therapy, beginning with the initial exercises that we've recommended, and then progressing through them. All of these exercises are for educational purposes only. They shouldn't replace medical advice, and they help to form the keystone of your rehab, but overall you need a really comprehensive rehabilitation program to get this condition better. So if you've got any questions for us, please leave them in the comment section below, and if you found the video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.